Now that you have a better idea of what Power BI Desktop is, I'm going to show you what Power BI Service is and what you can do with it. So there are two Power BI Service versions. You have Power BI Service, the online version, and then you have Power BI Report Server. And that version is for those companies that are not in the cloud yet, okay? So for Power BI Service, there are three main components. You have app workspaces, you have apps, and then you have datasets, you have reports, and then you have dashboards. Okay, so let's go through each component one by one. Workspaces. So workspace is basically a container for all your reports. So when you publish a report from Power BI Desktop into Power BI Service, you will be asked where you want to publish, which workspace you want to use. By default, there is one installed, which is My Workspace, and My Workspace is your personal workspace. So whatever you publish there, nobody else but you can see. So if you want to share reports with somebody else, you have to create a new workspace. Now, let's say that you are the manager for the marketing team and you have a few reports that you want to share with your group. Well, you create a marketing workspace and then you publish all the reports to the marketing workspace, and then you give access to your users in there and they will be able to see everything. Now, if you give access to the workspace, people will be able to edit, create new reports, they will be able to do what analysts and power users do. But there is another way to share reports, and this publish them as an app. So if you publish a report as an app, the user will be able to consume that report and it's read only. So it is a much easier and cleaner experience for information consumers, as they are called, you know, people that are only going to see the report, but they are not going to do anything else than that. So there are two options for apps. You can publish an app and then push it to your users, or you can have your users download the app. When to use when? Well, I would say if you have a standard report for your marketing team, push that to everybody, so they have it in front of them. But if there are ad hoc reports for a project or just an analysis that you wanted to do for some reason, budgeting or something, then it is better that they download it themselves if they need it, so their workspace doesn't get too crowded, okay? Now, the third component, if you remember, it was dashboards, reports, and datasets. Well, every time you publish something into a workspace, those three things get created, okay? So you get, for every report, a dataset, which allows users to actually use that dataset afterwards to create their own reports, which is very, very good. Then you get the actual report that you created. Of course, you can create new reports. And then you have dashboards. Dashboards are quite an interesting thing, because imagine again your marketing team where you have three or four reports, but I am responsible just for a set of products and I don't want all the reports. I just want this visual from here, these two visuals from there, and that visual from there. What I can do is I can pin those visuals to my dashboard and then I can create my own report based on everybody's work. So it is a fantastic way to cherry pick the insights that you want for yourself. Really, really neat, isn't it? So those are the three main components of Power BI Service. Now you might be wondering, okay, what other features do I have? Is that the only thing you can do? Well, you can, again, share reports with your colleagues. We talked about that. You can actually share reports publicly. And there is a function called publish to web that allows you to publish a report so everybody, anybody that has that link will have access to it. And you can actually embed that report on your website, on your web page. So imagine that you are a governmental agency and you want to share how you're spending money. So you can actually create a Power BI report and you can publish it to the web. So anybody that has access to the web will be able to see it. Do not use publish to web for private data, because if somebody gets a hold of that link, they will be able to see the report. So that is just for data that is public, nothing else. Make sure you remember that. It's very, very, very important. What else can you do? Well, you have the possibility to track live data. So let's say that you have sensors, you know, any Internet of Things device, or you have data that is live, like for example, Google Analytics that is pushing data, or sales that is pushing data, Marketo, and you want to follow that. Let's say that you have a customer service and you want to see how many calls you are receiving and how many calls you are answering, and you want to see that live, you have a possibility to push data live to Power BI and create a report and share it. Very, very, very easy. And then other features that you have is, you know, you have the possibility to export to PowerPoint. You don't have the possibility to export to PDF yet, but you can do it in the desktop. So very, very soon probably will come to the service. What else can you do? You can embed reports into SharePoint. You can embed reports in Teams. You can embed reports outside, but that is more for Power BI for the developers. You need a little bit more work for that. So there are tons and tons of things you can do. You have machine learning algorithms that will help you get insights. Yeah, there's tons and tons, but you have now a basic concept of what Power BI service is.